Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Freedom Factor. I'm your host, Oliver Bardwell, and this is a special episode. It's January 23rd, 2023. The great debates for school choice are going on. We were at the Capitol today with Governor Reynolds as she signed the proclamation for making the school choice week. And this episode is not about that. You know, we are all about freedom. And right now we have an issue that has been brought to our attention, and it's an issue about a young girl named Vivian. She has been taken from her parents, and ironically, I've met one of the parents, and I didn't realize it until now. I'm going to share my screen with you. So this is our Facebook page, and you can see this post. It's our good friend Sonia Swan asked us to share this. Here's all the activities of the day. You know, we were at the Capitol. There's Waldo right there. We watched Governor Reynolds sign the proclamation. It was amazing. We looked, you know, we watched some of the debates. But Vivian, I'm going to click on this. She's been taken from her parents. And Sonia is a good friend of ours. We did a lot of rallies with her over the last couple of years for medical freedom, to get the masks off our kids, et cetera. And she reached out to me the other day. We had a conversation about this last night. And ironically, a friend of mine called me just a few minutes ago, and he asked me if I'd heard about this. And I told him I had. I just heard about it. There's a court hearing on Thursday, and he asked me if I would go. And I had already decided I was going to go. I'd clicked going on this link. I'm going to include the link in this post. But he thought that I should talk to Jesse, and I've met Jesse. I just didn't put two and two together. This is Jesse in the picture there and his wife. So I'm going to call him. And Keith asked him if it would be okay if we did an interview. And because I've had a lot of questions about this, about what's going on, and there aren't a lot of details here. Although I think she did post some more details in the discussion. I mean, they're $18,000 in debt and legal fees. I believe part of it's because, you know, she has a terminal issue, and they're doing all the medical things, the current medical things, plus they're doing some holistic things as well. And I believe there may be even some discrimination going on from the doctor that's been taking care of them. So let's just call him and see if he's okay with doing a quick interview so you guys can get a better idea of what's going on. I've had a lot of people message me with questions. So Keith sent me his contact. He already talked to him. We'll see what happens here.
Hello?
Hello, Jesse?
Yep.
Hi, yep. This is Oliver Bardwell. How are you doing, man?
Pretty good. How are you doing?
Good, good. Yep. Yeah, Keith called me, and I've also talked to Sonia.
Yep.
So would you be okay with, you know, I've got a bit of an audience. We've got a group called Iowans for Freedom, and a lot of times they will show up. We've had some rallies last year, and they will show up to protect people's freedoms. And I don't know, maybe we can get a few people down to your court hearing, but I kind of wanted to talk to you.
Yeah, that sounds good.
I wanted to talk to you or your wife and give our members some of the details.
Right.
Do you have a...
Let me get her. I'm going to go downstairs.
You're going to talk to your wife?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to bring her downstairs that way because the kids will be running around up there if it's all out.
Well, we're really sorry to hear about this. I mean, it sounds like you've been going through quite a deal.
This is the fourth time this doctor's office has called DHS on me.
Wow. That's terrible.
Allegations all three times that they've been under. Doctor lied to my other doctors. About admitting my daughter, went to the hospital, get her admitted, supposed to go home, daughter's dying in her arms.
Wow.
Yeah, I have lots of evidence. I have recording of the doctors being the way they are.
Wow.
DHS, the last DHS lady came to our house for a visit after our doctor's office appointment. We had a visit with her. She was investigating the third time and brought my daughter home. My daughter was dying in my arms and she says, "What is going on here? Why is she in the hospital?" And I said, "We asked them to put her in the hospital. They told us to go home." She goes, "This is very unprofessional." She goes, "I'm not supposed to tell you this, but this is this mess." She goes, "This is not right."
Well, and it sounds like you've got some doctors in your court too, right?
Oh yeah. Yeah. I have the doctors that went on stand and depositions testified that we did not do none of this. We are good parents.
Right.
You know, and we went, what happened is the CF clinic, she's got cystic fibrosis.
Yeah.
So the CF clinic, we tried to email them for maybe about 2 months about getting an appointment with them.
Okay.
Never checked their emails. The daughter got sick. We had to go run around and find a doctor that would get the throat swab we need because it's a special throat swab that the CF clinic does. And it took 3 times to get the right throat swab with this lady, with one of the doctors. And after the third time, we found out that she ended up getting this thing called Pseudomonas.
Oh, wow.
My wife put you on speakerphone.
Sure.
And she ended up with this Pseudomonas, and they told our doctor, her name is Callie, one of our pediatricians, and she called the Blank Children's Hospital where the CF clinic is located in and said, we need to get this girl in the hospital and get her admitted because they admit you when you have Pseudomonas for 14 days and you do IV for 14 days, and that's how they take care of it. And they said, "Yep, bring her in." And so we get to the emergency room. No one knows we're coming. No one knows nothing, what's going on or none. They sent us home. We're like, "Why are we sending home?" I said, "See, they don't care about my daughter." And then the ER guy says, "It's not my decision. It was their decision."
Wow.
And hey, hold on a second. What's your wife's name?
Grega.
Grega, hi. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. You know, I talked to Sonia last night for quite a little bit, and she told me your story. And Sonia is a good friend of ours. I trust her judgment. And I was telling Jesse it was really ironic that Keith called me tonight again.
Yeah.
And he said, "Hey, you need to talk to these guys. This is ridiculous." And it sounds like he knows a lot about what's going on too, because you guys work together.
You know, it's not only affected me, it's affected Keith and us, our jobs, you know, and when I'm over here and I have to take off, you know, work to go and make sure that she's going to be okay. When, you know, I'm a parent, my daughter's sitting here dying in my arms, mine and my wife's arms, and I can't just get up and go to work. You know what I mean?
Wow. And what is it again, you know, that she has?
It's affected a lot of stuff, you know?
What is it again that she has?
Cystic fibrosis.
Okay. And that's...
But she's been infected with, like, a lot of other bacteria that have made her really sick. And the CF clinic specifically has refused to treat her for something called C. difficile.
Okay.
It's a really bad bacteria that can get overgrown in someone's stomach, and risk factors for it are antibiotic use and coming in contact with the hospital in general.
Wow. Well, Grega, how long has this been going on? Let me ask you this. Do you have your daughter now?
No. So she's removed from our care. She's with Jesse's sister, so my sister-in-law.
Okay.
We're actually here right now because we do get unlimited access to her. We can't be alone with her, though. So, like, we can't take her to the store. We can't take her to a doctor's appointment by herself. We have to be accompanied by Jesse's sister, our adult daughter, or my brother.
Wow. But how many other kids do you have?
So we have 6 kids all together. Vivian is the youngest.
Okay. And how long has this battle been going on?
Well, Vivian is 2.5. So it was shortly after she was born. We've been having this, we've been having issues with the CF clinic, almost immediately.
So how does it get from having issues to them reporting you? I mean,
so, I have concerns sometimes about medications, and I will ask questions about them, and they take my concerns and my questions as non-compliance.
Okay. And I understand you believe in some holistic ideas too, and some natural type medicine, and they don't really appreciate that.
No, they definitely don't. So when Vivian was in the hospital this last time, in August, she developed C. diff again, and we had already battled C. diff, so many times with, pharmaceutical antibiotics. And I was desperate, you know, I was asking her pediatrician at the time for a fecal transplant. And that's when you ingest somebody else's poop.
Yeah.
So that's one way to cure C. diff. But we did 5 rounds of antibiotics, and that's only after Vivian had C. diff for over a year undiagnosed. And and my husband continued to tell the CF clinic something is wrong with our daughter. She was at the 98th percentile BMI, and she dropped all the way down to less than the 3rd percentile failure to thrive in a year.
Wow.
And I continued to tell them something's wrong, and they would tell me, oh, it's malabsorption. Give her more enzymes. We have to give her enzymes every time she eats. And they would just tell me to give her more enzymes, and I would do that, but then she would become constipated, and that's a sign that you're giving too many enzymes. And they, you know, they've given me books and stuff, like when Vivian was a newborn, and I've read through all these books, and it explains the signs for malabsorption, if you're not getting enough enzymes, and then other reasons. And I was telling them, this is not malabsorption, but they just wouldn't listen to me. So Vivian got sick. Like, she already had the C. diff for a long time, and then she got sick. And we went to the CF clinic, and they weighed her, and she had lost almost a pound since her last appointment. And I told them in the last 10 days that Vivian was really sick and having diarrhea really bad. And they put her in the hospital, and they said that it was for pneumonia. But I was telling them nothing was wrong with her lungs. It's something else. There's something wrong with her stomach. So we got put into the hospital, what Vivian did, and they started her on IV treatment. It's called clindamycin. And a nurse. So Vivian had, I think it was 12 poops in 12 hours. And so this nurse, this awesome nurse, she helped us get a test for C. diff. It came back positive for C. diff, and it also came back positive for norovirus, which is food poisoning. So that's why Vivian had been so sick in the previous 10 days and lost all of the weight.
Okay, so you sound to me like
They called DHS this time. It was the 3rd time that they had called DHS on us. And they reported to DHS that we were not giving her her enzymes.
Oh, I lost the call. I'll call her back here. Sorry about that.
Hello?
Hey, sorry, I lost you. I lost you. I want to interject something. It sounds like you're a concerned and knowledgeable parent. How does it go from what are the reasons, do you think, that you've been reported and it's been mishandled so much?
So I think there's a little bit of bias just from me asking about more natural things, or asking if there's a different medication that maybe doesn't have this ingredient in it. That's that's how it started. And they take it as non-compliance.
Wow. Non-compliance. Yep. I have a sign from a protest that says compliance is not the cure. If I bring that, will they kick me out?
I don't know.
Anyway, so I wish we have members who are doctors. We have members who are holistic practitioners, naturopaths. I wish this was alive because they would jump in and talk about this. But my goal here is for people to understand what's going on, and then you would like people to show up on Thursday. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. So we want to get people there Thursday to support you guys. And just so the judge and the DHS and, the prosecuting attorney or whatever, however they do that, I don't know, but they know that people are watching.
Yeah. Yep. And that's another thing. So the DHS investigator, she didn't follow the Iowa code when she was conducting her investigation. She started her investigation with bias because there's a doctor here with allegations, and she did not gather evidence, not one single piece of evidence to back up the allegations. She just went with what the doctor said as fact. And we have a big, this is why we're in this situation.
Wow.
It's because this investigator did not do her job.
And I want to make it clear to our listeners that you have other doctors that have testified that have said, hey, these parents are doing a great job. Is that correct?
Our family doctor, which is Vivian's primary care doctor, and then her pediatrician and her chiropractor have all said that this child was never being abused. She was never in imminent danger, which is something the state has to prove before they remove your child from your care. The doctor with the allegations, he also told the DHS investigator before she removed Vivian that he does not think Vivian is in imminent danger if released to the parents, but she went ahead with the removal anyway.
Wow. How much experience does this DHS worker have? I mean,
I think she's worked
all together 16 months.
Yeah, all together months. She's worked for the department for 16 months. Yeah.
Okay. And they've, Keith had told me that they wanted you to sign off just to get it to go away, but it would be a strike against you.
Yeah. So there's so many parts to this that I wouldn't.
It sounds like it.
Thanks for bringing that up. So on our last, court hearing, which is still the same court hearing, it was just extended. That's going to happen on Thursday. It's a contested adjudication because we're contesting it. The judge made us a deal. She said, if we agree to the adjudication, so if we agree that we abused Vivian or neglected her, she would give us the child back immediately.
Wow. So they're trying to get you to admit to some wrongdoing so you can get Vivian back.
Yes.
This was after the DHS lady was on stand, and they told, and my attorney was doing his cross-examination, and the DHS lady pretty much testified that she didn't go look for evidence, didn't call the pharmacy, didn't do none of that, and her manager said she didn't have to or call any of our doctors, and the judge stopped it right then. And then told us all to leave the room. And then they came back.
So you think that...
And we told the judge when we got back in there, so this don't make sense to us. If we say we did it, you're going to let her come home with us. But if we say we don't, we can't be alone with her. That does not make sense to us.
Wow. That's interesting. Yeah.
And that's why everybody I need eyes on this. It needs to be, there's been so much, like I said, that four times DHS has done this to us. And all three times they were dismissed, and it was pretty much same allegations each time.
Yep, same allegations.
You know, and from what I've read, the fourth time that somebody's called DHS on you, that a DHS is supposed to contact the county attorney if there was false allegations and say, we need to prosecute these people. They won't because it's a doctor's office.
Okay. Oh, wow.
With them removing her, so that way the doctor's office don't get in trouble, because okay. They didn't remove our 5-year-old, they didn't remove our 17-year-old kid, just her.
Interesting. Okay, yep. So this has been, you know, Sonia's been, you know, pushing a donation page out and an event page that says Justice for Vivian, Bring Vivian Home. And it's 222 Fifth Avenue, Des Moines, Iowa, in room 220. Yep. And what time? 9 a.m. Okay.
Yep. We have court all day that day.
What's that? You have court all day?
All day. They scheduled it for all day.
And I understand this has cost you guys like $18,000.
I've been at 18 grand right now, yeah. Plus whatever I haven't got a bill yet from the rest of it.
Wow.
And then plus for Thursday, it'll add up, yes.
So what's a good time for people to come to this hearing?
Probably at 9.
9 a.m.? Well,
they can show up maybe, you know, a few minutes early, and maybe we can meet just in the common area for a second.
Would you like to do that at 8:30 or 8:45 or?
Yeah, 8:30, 8:45, because I'll probably be there at 8. I'm going to be like nervous, so I just.
Are you going to start right at 9, do you think, or?
It doesn't usually start. I think there might be some delay when the county attorney shows up and sees all the people there to support us.
Oh, okay. Okay, so that's, I'm also going to push it out there too, and I'll be there for sure. And if I can get any other Iowans for Freedom there, Freedom members there, I'm sure there will be some that will come down and support you. Even if it's just to sit there and show that you have support. And I'm sure they would love to talk to you and Sonia and get more of the story as well. But, you know, we're all about freedom, and we're about freedom for parents is for sure. And we've all heard some of these stories and how bad this can get. So,
You know, and one of our doctors that is testifying against them has her own practice, but she actually works for Unity Point too.
Well, she works for Blank Children's Hospital as a hospitalist.
But she's testified on stand against the Unity Point pretty much.
So she's testifying for you guys.
Yes, for us.
Against the place she worked for.
Oh my gosh. So she must really be invested and really believe in you.
And I just can't believe that we have this support and people are putting their reputations on the line for us to do the right thing.
You know, we've all seen how people have been persecuted for not following protocol. I've interviewed several doctors who have lost their jobs, I had to leave the hospitals because they wouldn't follow protocol in these last couple of years. So there's definitely more of an awareness of what this is all about, especially the minute you say you're not pro something. I'm not going to say it because I don't want this to get banned. But the minute you say you're not pro mainstream, whatever it is, you're likely to be discriminated against or have some issues. But so we're praying for you guys and sympathizing for you. And hey, everybody, please come out and support Vivian and help get Vivian home. And I'll let you guys get back to your evening. And I just want you to know that there are people that are thinking of you and are in your corner. So
I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
I appreciate
Jesse. You have a blessed evening as well. And I'll tell Keith that we're going to be there to support you guys.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Right. Well, yep. Take care. We'll talk to you soon.
You too.
Yep. Okay. Yep.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
So you heard it. That's the story. I've had lots of people reach out to ask me about it. We posted this. I've shared my screen a couple times. I'll do it again. But we posted this event that Sonia, it looks like there's already 19 people going and 26 people interested. But I'm going to post the link again in this video. Check it out. Come down. I'm going to be there at 8:30. So let's just show our support. You know, it is heartbreaking to hear this story. And we trust Sonia. We've partnered with Sonia from Iowans for Informed Consent on many issues, medical freedom issues. And this is really a medical freedom issue and a parent freedom issue. So let's show up and support this family. And if you have more questions, reach out to Sonia Swan. I tell you, I talked to her last night for 45 minutes, and I wish I would have recorded it because she knows this case inside and out, and I trust her. So everyone have a blessed night. Yay for school choice. We know it will pass tonight, and we are excited for it. So, and on the other side here, let's bring Vivian home.